Hello friends and welcome back to the channel. I know it's been a while. I've been a little preoccupied with some major news that's happening on Four Collectors that I'm not ready to reveal to the public just yet.
That's why you're a tease.
But it will be coming out soon, so stay tuned for that. But I do have to answer the call that's been put out there by some YouTuber friends and respond. So what you'll be seeing up ahead is some wonderful fours. Favorite uniform, what YouTube has done for me and my hobby, as well as some half grades. And lastly, I do owe one of my close friends a response to his call for VRs for sure. So stick around and let's check it out.
I can hardly wait.
Hello friends, I am John and I am a 3D 80s kid. To kick things off, my first VR will be for John over at Wade Boggs Fan, who asked us to talk about how our YouTube experience has increased our enjoyment of the hobby. And I would say that it has infinitely improved my experience. I went from being a siloed person, getting back into collecting for, over a year, and then putting myself out there in the YouTube space means that I have now developed all of these friends that I see as people I am going to enjoy spending my experience with in this hobby for the rest of my life. And I can't imagine going back to not having it. There's people I text with every single day. There's new people I'm constantly meeting, and everyone has just been so genuine and awesome. And I am super excited to be going to Cleveland for my first national here in July, and going to be staying in an Airbnb that's, I think we filled it up to like 13 YouTubers now, and that's going to be an amazing experience there, as well as then going to the gathering and meeting all these people who I kind of feel like I know them already with interacting with them. Some of it be via live streams or interviews, and some of it just being interacting through their channel and seeing what they're doing. And it's just been amazing. And, for those of you that think, we're showing off our, things when we reveal our cards and stuff, like we're just boasting and bragging.
All right. Nobody likes a show off.
I mean, on this side of the screen, it feels like I am sharing something I love with my friends. That, we all have this joined love of this collecting hobby, and it's just, we're looking to share it with people because we are passionate about it, and we can't stop talking about it, obviously, since we may have bothered to make these videos. So, John, thanks for doing this for the community here with asking us, to talk about this experience. And, big congrats on you for 2,000 subscribers, huge milestone, and you're just going to keep growing and growing.
That's great, John.
All right, up next, my best friend Scott over Reindeer Studios is doing a special VR for 5 years on YouTube, as well as 1,500 subscribers, both amazing milestones. Congratulations, Scott. And he asked us to talk about our favorite uniforms. So for me, I thought about this for quite a bit before I settled on the answer, and ultimately for me, it goes back to the whole, first love thing.
Never really can forget your first love, can you?
As in, when I first became a baseball fan, my first Little League team on the Braves, and the uniforms they were wearing then at the time, which ends up being what I settled on. And, this is my first ever Dale Murphy card, who was my childhood hero. Had the old Sports Illustrated poster with the white border of him in the place of honor above my bed. And this was my first card of him in that powder blue Braves jersey from that era, and followed up then with a little bit of a better shot of him launching a ball there with that, again, that uniform on this 84 Fleer card. So there you go, Scott.
How is that for you, Scott?
So up next is my response to Dan over at Old Sarge Collects, and he asked us to show four cards, the graded four in our collection, as well as give four shout outs to some channels out there in the hobby space. So to start things off, let me pull four of my favorite fours here, which is, let's start with this 1951 Bowman Yogi Berra in a 4 that I acquired through a trade with Chris from Missouri. This is my favorite Yogi Berra card, and so it became the choice for my post-war Hall of Fame player run. So, love this one of Yogi Berra. And yes, 4s look really nice in vintage. I agree, Dan. Up next, another favorite recent addition is this really nice 59 tops Frank Robinson that is just, you know, Dylan-centered. And can't even see any flaws on this card, and I don't bother to try. So, super nice card there. And then I've got 52 Bowman, Stan Musial. Dan and I are clubbies on this one. I think his is graded a 3, though, so he couldn't use it for this contest he's running. But I just love this one. It is... to me, it will look like the best Stan Musial card, and so I made it mine. All right. The last of my 4, I actually threw my favorite vintage non-Hall of Famer card in the mixed. And that is, there we go, the big clue with his famous sleeveless 57 tops card. I'd say that's a must-have for anybody that wants a card of a guy who clearly was a badass. Hell yeah! Hell yeah! So there we go. There is my foursome of cards. Hope you enjoyed that, Dan.
Of course he did.
And now for my 4 channel shoutouts. So I have been doing a video the last month, each of the last 2 months for 4 collectors, where I was shouting out 50 and then 51 channels of channels that I had actually watched at least one video of within that month for the community. And I actually have 4 more to throw out there that did not appear in either of those 2 videos. Some recent finds, actually. And one of those is Mark's Dodger Cards. And he is a guy who is doing super collecting of Dodgers.
Yeah, I hate the Dodgers. That's okay.
You know, we'll forgive him. You know, some people like the team that's near them locally. So, but great cards he's pulling there from all the way pre-war, all the way through. He's trying to collect it all in much the way of like Carlisle Rood with the Braves and Scott over at Ranger Studios with Cleveland. So doing great things there. So check him out. The next one I wanted to cite is someone that's mostly on Instagram, but is trying to branch out into YouTube and ends up being an anomaly in our hobby, which is mostly full of men, as this is a woman presenting as a true collector of cards, and that is Jenny Marie Sports Cards, who, because of that fact, I'm finding that she has almost as many interviews on channels as she does long format videos. And coming from Instagram, her style at this point is a little bit more on the Instagram-y side to me, with catchy music and that editing vibe that you get more from Instagram. That's not really my jam, but I still want to give, love to someone, on the women's side, because, when you go to shows, you are someone that does not have a collection of people that are like you. This is a probably 99% male dominated hobby, which then also leads to the unfortunate thing that you see of women being used as props at show tables, or you see that in breaking, where they're just there to attract more men eyeballs. So shout out to Jenny Marie, who is an honest to goodness true collector, has some great cards going where she's collecting with her husband of vintage black Hall of Fame players, has a great Ernie Banks run going. So check her out. Up next, there is a Glove and Beyond TV, which is a guy who is doing some really funny, elaborate video effects in his videos.
You need to step your game up.
That you should see to check it out. If you're looking for a little more comedy bent with some quick videos, definitely check out a Glove and Beyond TV. Links for all these will be down below if you want to check them out. And the last one that actually surprised me that I missed is The Card Pile. This is a guy who is collecting vintage to junk wax in terms of baseball, football, I think hockey, as well as some non-sport with like some wrestling. I saw some Star Wars cards out there, but a guy who collects lots of cool stuff, and you should certainly check out. And that is who is actually going to lead me into my next VR, which is for his channel.
Oh, nice segue.
Good blend.
All right, so the card pile asked us to look at half-graded cards, because, you know, there's a lot of people that just hunt down, like, specific number grades, and so some of the times you can actually get bargains for the 0.5 graded cards, because, you know, people won't be specifically searching for them like they do sometimes with the numbers. And, you know, and I've already mentioned plenty of times, if you want something a little bit nicer than a 4, you step up to that 4.5 mark. So let me show a few of my 4.5 graded cards that I got. And that would be starting with this 57 Whitey Ford. That looks sweet there. And how about this really nice photo quality on this 4.5 of Brooks Robinson from the 61 set. Gotta love the little Oriole patch on the shoulder, too. All right. And now moving ahead to 63, we've got Jim Cott with his starting the wind-up pose there. Really nice. And this one happens to come from the Don's Field of Dreams collection. So there we go. All right. And last but not least, a card I might have shown a few times, but let's do it one more time in honor of Theo's VR.
One more wouldn't hurt.
And that would be the 71 Tops, Roberto Clemente. That little half grade higher just makes all the difference, doesn't it, folks? All right. Beautiful card and just a classic pose of Roberto. Possibly his best looking Tops card in existence. So there you go. That's for you, Theo.
I'm sure he'll appreciate it.
I think that will be the final time I will do this on this channel. I do have one collaboration in the works that will not be on my channel that will be coming soon. So I think most of the community will have their eyes on that one. So
it's always tease, tease, tease.
So thanks again to Wade Boggs Fan, Reindeer Studios, Ol' Sarge Collects, The Card Pile, and even my friend Clemente Collector. So everyone, I'll see you next time. But if you like what you see, why don't you click on the video that's going to be on the screen here in a second, and keep watching. And I will also happily tease Theo to no end. And I will also happily tease Theo to no end. And I will also happily tease Theo to no end.
I thought we were friends, John. What happened to Four Collectors? I am your friend. I told you about the cart.
Oh, the Reign of Terror is back!